We'll have more on the other names on the Eagles' radar later in the show. But for now, hello and welcome into Sports Night, presented by your local Chevrolet dealers alongside Neil Hartman. I'm Marshall Harris.
Well, Marshall, hockey is back. The NHL and its Players Association reached a tentative agreement early this morning, ending the league's 113-day lockout. The new collective bargaining agreement is for 10 years with an opt-out clause following the eighth year. CBA still needs to be ratified by both the league's board of governors and the players. Here are Commissioner Gary Bettman and NHLPA Executive Director Don Ophir following a 16-hour negotiating session that ultimately led to a resolution.
And I want to thank Don Ophir because he and the Players Association, as well as the people that work with me at the league, went through a long, tough period, and we still have more work to do, but it's good to be at this point.
Any process like this in the system we have is difficult. It can be long. I've said repeatedly throughout this process that, you know, and somebody would say, what do you see ahead? And the answer was, you get up tomorrow and try and find a way to do it. And you keep doing that until you find a way to succeed. Hopefully, we're at a place where all those things will proceed fairly rapidly and with some dispatch. And we'll get back to what we used to call business as usual just as fast as we can.
Here are some of the details of the new CBA. It contains a mutual opt-out clause after 8 years. The players and owners agreed to a 50-50 split of hockey-related revenue. There's a 7-year limit on player contracts. You can add an 8th year to re-sign your own player. Each team was also given 2 amnesty clauses that need to be used prior to the 2013-2014 season. They cannot be used for this upcoming season. The salary cap will be just over $70 million this season, then drop to $64 million for the 2013-14 season. And there will be a $200 million in revenue sharing. The return of hockey is a nice 80th birthday gift for Flyers chairman Ed Snyder.
I don't want to look back at anything. I mean, we've got a deal now, and I'm just thrilled, and I'm thrilled for our fans. I'm thrilled for our players. And I'm thrilled for everybody involved in hockey, all the people that have been hurting. I've felt terrible for them. I think, you know, we look at it and we try to think in terms of the league in general, just like the players look at it and try to look at the players in general. And there are some things that have to be done that may not be something that, you know, we would necessarily care about, but there's a lot of teams that are hurting, and, you know, we want the league to be strong, and I know the players want the Players Association to be strong, and you get into these situations, and it's very, very unfortunate.
Some of the Flyers took to Twitter after they got the news. Claude Giroux saying, quote, it's a beautiful day for hockey. Hashtag game on. Hashtag miss the game. This is from Max Talbot. Thanks. Sorry, fans, media, and everyone affected by this lockout. Never a fun situation. Now let's go play some hockey. For more reaction to the end of the lockout, Lisa Hillary has inside access.
113 days of lockout futility has come to an end, and you, the fans, are indifferent. Eric says 2 lockouts in recent memory hurt a lifelong fan. Glad the whole season's not lost. We'll watch, but no live games without incentives. Ben says, I'm dropping my season tickets. And this from Amanda. I am pumped hockey is back. First game of the season will be my husband, son, and I decked out in our jerseys. Let's go Flyers. While the reaction from fans has been mixed, NHL players are grateful they can get back to work.
We're happy to be back. It's a long process that was, like I said, was not fun to go through, but it happens in professional sport. And like I said, it's tough on everyone involved, including the fans.
I was pretty excited, and I think I'm not the only one that was waiting for that that wake-up call for a long time, and to have our game back, it's obviously pretty exciting.
You know, it's obviously a good time for everybody, I think, players, owners, and fans, to know that the game's back, and now it's just a matter of getting the anticipation for that first game of when the puck drops, and the next week should be fun for everybody.
You go through things, and at the time, you're not sure why you're going through them or what's going on, but sometimes when you can look back and be like, wow, that was worth it, hopefully this is one of those situations.
Few players have all the details of their new CBA. Jody Shelley would not elaborate on specifics, only saying he's relieved it's over.
There's been a lot of damage done. We know that with the fans, and as long as hockey comes out being a better product and being better for everyone, I guess that's all we can ask for at this point.
You know what? I wasn't a fan of the game either the last few months. You know, it's just tough to watch, and just to have the game back. I mean, I think the fans are going to love it.
Nearly 200 players are on the way back from overseas. 11 are Flyers, the most of any NHL team to have played in Europe during the lockout. Danny Briere and Claude Giroux were forced to cut their European experience short because of injuries. Giroux responded when asked about his health.
Yeah, that's one of the reasons why I came back, to make sure I'm 100%. And I spent a lot of time on rehab and I'm making sure that if the NHL does come back, I'm 100% and I'm ready to go.
Paul Holmgren has yet to comment on the new CBA until it's signed, sealed, and delivered. The Flyers GM refrained from doing interviews on his player's status or injuries.
All NHL players under contract before they get back to work have to take a physical. Jody Shelley telling me that process could start as soon as Wednesday. Reporting from Voorhees, Lisa Hillary, Comcast Sportsnet.
Thank you, Lisa. Coming up at 11:30, we've got much more on today's huge news on our Sports Night special. Flyers are back. Full hour of hockey talk hosted by John Borick. You'll be joined by Tim Panaccio, Al Morgani, Keith Jones, and Lisa Hillary. Check out Flyers Are Back tonight at 11:30 on Comcast Sportsnet. Chris Pronger will attend Flyers training camp but will not be on the ice. The Flyers captain last played on November 19, 2011. Pronger has been suffering from post-concussion syndrome and has not been cleared to play. 38-year-old Pronger is a veteran of 18 NHL seasons, last three with the Orange and Black.